Hi everyone, welcome back to the DevOps Lab. I'm Damien, and this week we are talking with my colleague April Edwards about deploying Azure Static Web Apps if you're invested in Azure DevOps. It's a cool set of technologies, something you don't want to miss. Check it out. Hey everyone, welcome back to the DevOps Lab. I'm Damien, and today we're talking about Azure Static Web Apps with April Edwards. April, thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Damien, for having me.
So Azure Static Web Apps, super cool new product. But from a DevOps perspective, which is what we talk about, how do I do this? Well, let's start from the beginning, actually. Let's start with what Azure Static Web Apps are and what they're for.
Yeah, so I mean, I've done some demos for, you know, in some live events and customers, and, you know, they just had a really simple website that they want to decouple from a server and had just a really a static site, whether it's using something like HTML, CSS, JavaScript, or maybe hosting some images. And you could do that from a storage account before, but now we actually have the Azure Static Web App service, which is super cool because we've enabled CI/CD and ease of deployment into this product. So the other cool thing is, you know, when you did stuff with storage before, it was in like a single point in your blob storage account. Now with an Azure Static Web App, we can geographically distribute this web app. And this is great for any kind of your front end web apps doing static content. And instead of having a whole server back end to manage and everything else, we can connect to our APIs using Azure Functions. So that's a massive win for this product. And it integrates into, you know, Azure DevOps and GitHub Actions, and it gives you opportunity to do custom domain names, and you can do SSL cert. So there's a great amount of functionality that they've baked into the product, and it's just gone GA.
Right. And that's probably the important part, right? When we last spoke about it on this show, it was in a public preview or private preview, but it's GA now. So it's available to absolutely everybody.
It is. And they've done some really cool things where, you know, they have built-in libraries and frameworks built right into the offering. So you can, you know, deploy stuff like anything with Angular, React, Vue, or maybe even Blazor. And you don't need server-side rendering at all, or, you know, and it takes that away. It takes away that overhead. Because as a developer, you don't want to have to deal with the server, the maintenance, the upkeep, the patching, and all those things. And it's great for static sites for things like Gatsby or Hugo as well.
Yeah, awesome. I've seen a few great implementations of it, people's blogs and things like that. It's super great for that kind of thing. But so let's talk about the DevOps perspective. So basically, you know, I've got my code, it's a static web app, I don't know, Hugo or whatever I'm using, but I'm invested in Azure DevOps, right? How easy is it to get that into, you know, production in a nice way?
Cool. So again, like I talked about, we can push our code. Anytime we make a code change to our static site, it can kick off a pipeline. So let's actually go through the process of starting up an Azure Static Web App from nothing or from just our code. So I'm going to pull up my screen here. And I've, you know, my organization's heavily invested in Azure DevOps as a product. We use it day in and day out. So now we want to implement it. So we have our code in a repo. I have my Static Web App code here. It's all tidy, ready to go. And what I need to do actually is I need to go in and create my static web app in the Azure portal. So if I go into the Azure portal, I've already carved out a resource group, but I want to go and create this static web app. So I'm going to go ahead and create my static web app here. And it's super simple. It spins up in a couple of minutes. So we're going to go through and create this from scratch. And I'm going to show you how easy and quick it is. So I'm already going to define my resource group. I'm going to call this, I'm so bad at naming these things, right? Always so bad at naming these things. It's the worst. And so I'm going to put generic name in now. So hopefully I don't lose it, but you know, you always do. There are some great hosting plans as well. So I'm going to use the free plan, and I just want to kind of highlight the hosting plans that are out there because, you know, if you're running, you know, maybe a blog website with Hugo or Gatsby, or you're just running a static site, you can use this kind of free tier for kind of hobby and personal projects, anything that doesn't need to scale too heavily. Because you get two custom domains per static web app on the free tier. You get, you get a pretty sizable app size running, and you get three staging environments. And if anyone's ever used the Azure Web App service, the staging environments are huge. You can spin up one web app and then have those staging so you can test your code before it goes to your production or your live site. So that's really cool. So I'm going to use the free tier here. I told you it was geographically replicable. It isn't currently only available in a few regions, but more regions are absolutely coming. So I'm going to select West Europe because I'm based here in the UK. So for me, that makes sense. But if I were based in the US, I could absolutely pick a site or replicate that static web app closer to my users. Now, deployment details. You will see here that GitHub is an option, yes. But remember, we're using Azure DevOps. So I'm going to go ahead and select Other. We're going to review and create this web app, and it's going to analyze, it's going to deploy it for us. So in a few clicks, it's verified everything. Great. Let's deploy it. So we're going to wait for this to deploy. Now, the one bugbear with the static web app currently is that you have to copy your key from the web app when it creates. But there is actually a way to automate that I'll show you in a second. So it's not going to be completely manual in the future. So I've created this web app. We've called it SDD site just because terrible naming. But we have to get a deployment token over to our Azure repo so we can connect to this web app. So I'm going to just copy this here while I'm here. You can do this at a later step, but I find to just copy this here, move over to my actual repo here and go, right, now I'm going to create a pipeline net new for the Static Web App. So I do already have a pipeline in play just in case, but I want to create a new pipeline here. So I want to do this from net new. So again, our code sitting in the Azure repo, Git repository. I'm going to select my repo that I want to choose. I'm going to use an existing YAML file. For me, that's a little bit easier. We do some cool things in the YAML. So in the YAML file here, we're going to trigger it off of any kind of pull request or merge into main. So anytime we update our code, we can add a branching strategy in there, and it goes straight to deployment. The other thing that I do is, now there's a little bit of an automation here with PowerShell. So I talked about how I had to kind of copy that token. There is a way in the future, there's a way you can automate it now with PowerShell. So that is actually in the script. But here in the settings, we just call the YAML task to deploy the Azure Static Web App. It calls the application, the API location, and the output location here. Now the big piece you have to remember here is for the environment, we need that API token. So that was what I just copied. So I need to go into my variables file here, add my variable. Now, I want to keep this value secret because, well, don't really want to show the world. I'm going to call it token because I reference it as token in my YAML script. I'm going to go ahead and save that. So I've referenced that token here. I've just copied and pasted it in. And again, this PowerShell script here will enable you to copy that token. But for practical purposes today, we're just going to run it super simple. So I'm going to go ahead and run this. It's going to create our pipeline for us. And it's going to run this pipeline. So if I go into my web app now and click on it, nothing. Now my static web app is live, but I don't have any content in it. So we're going to let this run. And now, as we know, when we run a pipeline, this is a great time to grab a cup of coffee, a cup of tea, or chat about anything else. So Damien, is there any questions you have about the static web app service in Azure DevOps as of yet?
Well, what? One thing that I noticed as well, when you clicked on that Azure Static Web Apps, it came up really fast. I do remember whenever you start an app service and it kicks off for the first time, you know, sometimes it takes a little while, but the Static Web Apps pretty quick to get in there.
Go ahead.
No, I was going to say, the other thing I noticed was the Azure Static Web App task that's there is a native task. It's an out of the box task, right? You're not importing any extensions or anything?
No extension. So that is a native task built into Azure DevOps itself. So all you need to do is go into the task manager, type in static web app, and it'll pull up that task and import it. Now I've copied and pasted, already created this YAML because I know it works. I say this, I already have a failure on my PowerShell, but that's okay. we're not using that component in this pipeline.
Okay. Great. So yeah, I was expecting when you said we had to do a little bit of work that you might be writing scripts to do your deployments and stuff. But the fact that is an Azure Static Web App step that's in there, it's very cool. Yeah, we don't have to add anything else. It's kind of there by default.
Yeah.
So that failure in the PowerShell, just to make sure I'm clear, that PowerShell was about connecting to the Azure Static Web App.
Yeah. So that enables us to take that token key that we had to save and manually do, and then import that in. So that task runs it, pulls it, and puts it into an actual Azure key vault. So if we go back into my my Azure subscription here, into where I have my static web apps, I have an Azure key vault here to hide that in. So that's really cool. So Damien, while this pipeline's running, do you have any other questions that you'd like to ask?
So the first thing I noticed was super fast, Azure Static Web Apps for a start. The second thing I noticed is you mentioned that the deployment task with the, you know, the token and stuff like that was something that was a little bit tricky. I was actually expecting you to have to write some scripts to like deploy the application. But there's a task you were using, which is the deploy Azure Static Web App. Is that like an out-of-the-box one or an extension or anything?
So it's an out-of-the-box one. So when they went GA with Azure, the Azure DevOps capability to deploy this with, what they wanted to ensure is that any developer could, you know, push their code to a branch and easily get these tasks in there. So if I go into the tasks on the right-hand side here, I can go and type in Static Web App, and we have deploy Azure Static Web App. So when I actually put this task into my pipeline, this is what I used to do it. So I just put in my app location, the output location, et cetera, and the API location. So I'll be able to, I can fill those in, and then I can add the task. The one piece here about the token does get added as well. So you just need to then add that token manually. So in this script, we do have that PowerShell task to add that token as well.
Okay. Yeah. So I was going to ask, that PowerShell task is all about just pulling that token and putting it in there. Is that correct?
Yeah. It actually sits in Azure Key Vault. So if I go back into my subscription here, I actually have an Azure Key Vault that's hiding that key. So I'm calling that key from that Azure, from the Key Vault itself, so that I don't have to cut and paste that over. So while it is a manual process at, you know, at this point in time, there is a way to automate it, and that is going to be automated in the future as well.
Okay, awesome. Yeah, really cool. So that pipeline, could we have a look at where we're at?
Absolutely. So we have a successful pipeline. It's basically checked out the Static Web App. It's deployed the site. It's gotten that, you can see that it's gotten the deployment token in the tasks here, and that's that PowerShell script going and fetching that token, and then using that to connect to the Azure Static Web App and authenticate to that to the API.
And then that deployment happened, and we're up and running.
Yeah, and we're up and running. So if we go into our website here, and we click on it, we have our Azure Static Web App now.
Nice, cool.
Awesome.
And yeah, again, like when you clicked on that, that shot up really fast. One of the advantages of Static Web Apps, I guess.
They're wicked fast. And again, you know, in the days of people lifting and shifting web servers into the cloud, it's like you have the overhead, the management, and everything else that goes along with it. And Azure Web Apps are really cool. But for something like a static site, this is awesome. And it enables, you know, any organization or customer or even person just running a blog to be able to set up a website on the free tier, super easy to use, and you can automate the whole thing end to end.
That's very cool. Now, we'll make sure we put some stuff in show notes about where to get started and stuff. What are your recommendations? Like, where should people look to get the best information about how to get started with Static Web Apps?
So we have written some great docs on docs.microsoft.com, and there's a tutorial that I may have written about deploying an Azure Static Web App with Azure DevOps.
Awesome. That's what a coincidence.
I know, right?
Awesome. Oh, look, thanks so much for showing us this. I know there's a lot of people excited by this Azure Static Web Apps, and it's really good to know if you're on Azure DevOps, then you know, there's a great deployment story for it as well.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So thank you again. Thanks everybody for watching, and we'll see you next time on another DevOps Lab.